take us through the final
flight
seconds
directors,
until
go for launch. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff, go Super Heavy, go Starship. Thanks for all the historic flights, Pad 1.
Catching downrange. Booster Raptor chamber pressure nominal.
Booster and ship nominal power and telemetry.
Alright, we are about 45 seconds into flight. We're still getting the rattle here at Star Factory. We are seeing 33 out of 33 Raptor engines lit on Super Heavy as it arcs across the Gulf. Coming up next on Max Q. So in about 30 seconds, we're going to see the engines start to shut down on Super Heavy. You'll see them kind of shut off in separate banks until we've just got those three center engines that never stop running for this process. And then looking for six ship Raptors. All right. Miko coming up in about 10 seconds. See the engines throttling down.
Booster engine cutoff.
Ship ignition.
Stage separation.
Spec burn startup.
All right, successful hot staging maneuver. So we've got 12 of the 13 engines lit back up on boosters, so it's doing its boost back. Real excitingly,
ship,
though,
ship
we've got six out of six Raptors lit on ship there, so it's now going to continue to make its ascent into outer space. Meanwhile, this boost back is happening. We're using those 13 engines. So everything, well, 12 out of the 13, and then we go down to three, and then we're going to shut down for the end of boost back. That's sending Super Heavy back
ship
towards its planned splashdown zone in the Gulf. Right after we finish this boost back burn, we're also going to separate the hot stage. This will be the final time
boost back
that we're
burn,
doing
shutdown.
This is... All right, there's the end of the boost back burn. We should be seeing the hot stage. There. All right, so for booster, this is one of the main things we're trying to get is going to be this landing burn. Oh, that's so you can see the hot stage kind of making its way towards the very the left side, so that's the bottom of the booster. It's about to pass right in front of where you can see some of that prop dump happening.
From landing burn start, where we'll first ignite the center 13 engines, then bring that down to 5 to slow down the booster for landing. And finally, that will come down to 3, and we'll cut all of them off while we're still about 200 meters in the air. So booster is going to see a bit of a harder thing.
Booster landing burn start it. Booster landing burn shutdown.
And there we heard it. Booster landing burn shutdown. We saw a 13 to 5 to 3 V3 demonstration. And into the water we go.
All right, less than a minute to go. So we are going to see the three RVACs, the vacuum optimized engines, shut down first. And then we'll shut down those three center engines. So we should be a little under a minute until SECO. Just a reminder, this is putting us into a suborbital trajectory, so we're intentionally just going slow enough that we're not going to achieve full orbit. This puts us on a course where those engines shut off, and no matter what, we're coming back.
Starship is in terminal guidance.
In the Indian Ocean. All right, terminal guidance. So we should start seeing the shutdowns come up in just a couple seconds. Less than 30 seconds to go in this ship ascent burn. All right, RVACs have shut off. Three more to go.
Ship engine cutoff.
All right, welcome back, everybody. If you're just now joining us, where the heck were you? But we are getting ready for payload deploy. That's going to start once we get the payload door open. That should be happening, or at least starting, within the next minute or so. It's been a really cool flight so far. Quick look inside the payload. We've got 8 Starlink simulators getting ready to make their way into outer space. But great flight so far. Booster able to make it all the way to its splashdown and landing burn experiment. So that was really exciting to see. We got ship on orbit, nominal orbital insertion. So right on the money with its trajectory. And now we're ready to start tackling a couple of in-space objectives. So next up, we are currently venting down the nose cone, essentially the payload area of Starship, as we get ready to open up this payload door. We were able to do this successfully for the very first time on our last flight, on Flight 10. Oop. Hal got ahead of me. Looks like he's opening up the payload door already. All right, looks like we got the door open. Coax it out. Get it moving, Jake.
There we go. All right, first one going out. All right, first one's deployed. Getting ready for the second one here. We do a little reset back to the center position.
Yeah, it takes about a minute for each one.
Looks real smooth too. They made a couple of tweaks to those rails. If you watched the last ones, it had a couple of bumps on the way out, but moving out super clean this time.
Yeah, and as noted earlier in the show, but definitely worth repeating, Starship will deploy Starlink's more advanced V3 satellites, adding 60 terabits per second of capacity to the network per launch. So that's 20 times more than each Falcon 9 launch does today. Just incredible.
Yeah, and anybody that's been following Starship, you know Starlink's kind of the MVP for these flight tests, where it's not only giving us the views we're seeing right now, but also just real-time data through every phase of flight. So we've got a couple dozen cameras on Starship. We've also got a bunch of cameras spread across the globe, including out in the Indian Ocean, where we've got our fun buoys floating. There goes another one. I mean, we're using Starlink to bring all of this together. It's our drone shots you see here from our great team down here at Starbase, all connected. So Starlink not only giving us cool views off the planet, but also on the planet, help bring everybody along for all these Starship flights. I think that's number 4. Somebody check my math. Yeah, we've got 4 Starlink terminals on the outside of Starship. It uses that to talk to the constellation. And through that, we actually get about 120 megabits of bandwidth for our downlink. That's our real-time HD video, all of our telemetry. So it's not just kind of giving us these cool views inside, but it's giving all that engineering data in real time, including reentry, when normally a plasma layer builds up and blocks you out. Starlink, powerful enough of a frequency that we're able to kind of punch through that and still get that live view. Next one out the door. There we go.
All right, yeah, Starlink is the world's largest satellite constellation operating in low Earth orbit to deliver high-speed, low-latency broadband internet. This provides internet access to people around the world, many of who have never had connectivity before. Oh. Right, today Starlink serves more than 150 countries, territories, and other markets with over 7 million active customers and counting. To meet the global growing demand for high-speed internet, SpaceX expanded its factory over in Bastrop, Texas, which is just outside of Austin, and also introduced Starlink Mini, as well as an upgraded version of the Starlink Standard Kit.
Yeah, and one thing to note about this satellite deploy is that they will be following the same suborbital trajectory of the ship. So these dummy sats will not be going in orbit. We do expect them to burn up on reentry.
Couple more to go. I promise one of these days we'll deploy in daylight. But we're basically trading deploy in the dark so we get those re-entry views for the daytime. All right, I think we got one more to go.
Right now, with payload deploy complete, Starship will now close its payload door and continue to coast around Earth to the Indian Ocean.
Here we go.
Oh, Raptor ignition. And shut down.
All right, there was that Raptor relight. Looks like engine 3, full duration. As Dan mentioned, that's a third attempt, and we just did it three times in a row. So congrats to the team, the ship team, Raptor team. And then there we heard nominal second orbital insertion. All right, so congrats everyone on the milestone. That was awesome to see. We're 3 for 3. We're going to take another break, and we'll be back for re-entry at about T plus 45 minutes. We'll see you soon.
All right, welcome back, everyone. The ship is currently re-entering Earth's atmosphere. As a reminder, we don't plan to recover the spacecraft today, but rapid and reliable reusability is the ultimate goal.
Yeah, the light show has already begun. You can see plasma starting to build on the windward side of the rocket there. And, you know, re-entry is a critical phase of flight, and we need information on how the ship systems perform. Reentry is also extremely demanding portion of flight because we need the ship to scrub off all of the energy we used to launch the rocket. So remember, the 33 engines plus the 6 engines on ship that we used to get up into space, we now are using aerobraking essentially to scrub off all that energy.
Yeah, so re-entry so far is looking pretty good. You can see that plasma field. Also, again, with those missing tile experiments, especially, we're putting the ship through a lot today, but things are looking pretty good so far.
Yeah, we're looking good. I do want to remind people that we are pushing ship to the limits. We've done a lot of these missing tile tests. We did it back in Flight 10. Every time we do it, we throw something new and the ship makes it through. This time, we're really pushing it. We've removed these tiles in some of the spots that see the highest level of heating. And we removed tiles that have zero backup protection underneath. So there's essentially just bare steel. We addressed that, changed some of our prop dump conups though, so should not be seeing that this time around. And a reminder, so this camera is, we see some of the heat rate picking up a little bit. And this camera is embedded right in the end of one of those forward flaps, so you see it moving around. That's the flap adjusting to maintain control. Looks like we're getting into our bank maneuver. Now power sliding through the atmosphere.
External temperatures are coming down. Vehicle is now at maximum dynamic pressure.
That's where we have a lot of flight history.
Starship is transonic, starting the belly flop phase of flight.
Yep, that belly flop phase that we perfected in the suborbital campaigns, we're entering that now.
Right, starting to get those Raptors ready. Should be 2 minutes away from landing burn. Again, we're going to do a flip. After we ignite those engines, we'll go from 3 down to 2 for the final phase of the landing burn and look for another soft splashdown, hopefully, by our buoy and drone, which are hanging out, ready and waiting for a ship.
Seeing all three center engines have entered the chill phase.
All right, less than a minute to go.
The ship is making its turn for final approach.
And here's this kind of aggressive final turn that would essentially position it so it's right behind the launch and catch tower. Flaps holding strong. Landing burn in just under 20 seconds.
Ship landing startup.
There's our landing burn. Three down to two.
Starship has landed.
I as we said, we're not planning on recovering the ship today. Hey, welcome back to Earth, Starship. We are down in the Indian Ocean.